career of Mamo Jajai. The man nicknamed the Cobra, making his way towards the boxing ring for his 30th professional contest tonight. Born in Kosovo, man who escaped the ravages of war in that country when the family relocated to Switzerland when he was just 15 years of age. Soon afterwards, he found the noble art. And since that time, he's compiled an impressive resume in both the amateur and the professional ranks. 55 fights as an amateur, winning 40, 30 of them inside the distance. Three-time national Swiss champion, three-time silver medalist as well. And as a professional, he's compiled a perfect legend so far, but he's never faced anything like this type of atmosphere. But he brings plenty of ambition, he brings heavy hands, and he brings a 6'5" frame into the boxing ring. The man alongside him in his spectacles is Angelo Bellina, and he opines the articulate Italian Swiss that David Haye is an old man, and this man, with his ambition and punching power, is going to derail the ring return of David Haye by scoring a spectacular victory here tonight. He's characterized the fight.
And next to make his way to the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, former cruiserweight world champion, former heavyweight world champion from South London, David Haye.
Germany in November 2009 to defeat Nikolai Valuev. He wants to scale those heights in the heavyweight division once again. And this, the second contest of his ring return, after his 131-second destruction over Martin Murray, he somehow has a ranking of 10th in the WBA. He makes short work of that opponent. He was happy to divest himself of any ring rust that they have accumulated during his fourth 3.5-year layoff. And he is all smiles as he approaches the arena, because he's approaching his place of work, his place of business, and the place where he feels most comfortable. So that he's born to be a boxer, said that he discovered his talent as a 3-year-old toddler. And since that time has dedicated himself to being the very best he can be. And he feels that at his best, he is the very best. Facing an opponent that he fully expects to dispatch in impressive fashion, but it comes with a fair amount of pressure, because on this ring return, David Haye knows that there is no margin for error. He not only has to win, he has to look good doing it in order to keep himself relevant in the heavyweight division. He's got the temperament, and he feels that he still has the physical tools to do that, as he breaks into a beaming grin at the back of the O2 Arena. Ring walk to the familiar anthem of Eight Note Stoppingers now. Been using this tune
floor and not out of the contest. But how will he fare against the high level of opposition? Use the field that he has, the equipment, the tools, the timing, the reflexes and the punching power to get back to the very top. And this is another step in what he feels will be the rewarding process. Really stepping up the love that is cascading down from every seat in the O2 Arena here. And taking his time on the way to the boxing ring, where Arnold the Cobra Jajai is waiting rather pensively in the red corner. David Haye making him endure this wait. His new trainer, Shane McGuigan, steps between the strands. Holds them open for David Haye. But he is savoring every moment of this ring walk. So into the boxing ring. A quick high five with all of the officials in the MC. Before taking up residence in the blue corner, there we see the tail of the tape. Arnold Jajai, taller by 2 inches, heavier by some 13 pounds. So he has the edge in physical assets, but he most certainly won't have the edge in speed, and we suspect he won't have the edge in punching power. And David Haye demonstrate those qualities with his superior speed as well. Odds are, given the knockout percentages of these fighters, this contest is not going to go the scheduled 10-round distance.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, from the sold-out O2 Arena here in London, England, it is time for the main event of the evening. 10-round for boxing is scheduled in the heavyweight division. Presented by Haymaker Promotions and sponsored by IM360, Maxi Muzzle. And Volteron, mentioned by the point of control, the steward in charge, Mick Collier. The three judges scoring at ringside in the 10-point mark system, Jeff Hines, Ian John Lewis, and Bob Williams. When the action begins inside the ring, referee in charge, Terry O'Connor. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready, the fighters are ready, the world is ready. In 29 professional bouts, his record, 27 victories, including 25 knockouts. Just 2 defeats, here's the final pride of South London, England, the former UFI, WBC, WBO, WBA, heavyweight world champion, the former WBA, heavyweight champion of the world, here is the
So referee Terry O'Connor brings the two boxers together to receive their final instructions.
You know what I expect, but second, best of all, here we go.
So during that brief coming together, the height advantage enjoyed by Arnold Jajai apparent. How much will he be able to capitalize on that as he prepares to square off against the speedy, elusive David Haye as he continues his ring return? So here we go then, the first of the scheduled 10 3-minute rounds in this heavyweight main event.
the bunch of advertising logos all over the ring. The four coming together. And David Hay immediately looking to tee off with hooks and uppercuts. The giant walking in behind a high held guard. His body is wide open and his elbows are.
Tremendous strain, man. And it didn't hit him close, just hit him in the side of the glove, but enough to jerk his head back. He's in trouble here. David's just changed his tactics a little bit. He's trying to get him to open up. Jirjai walked into him to begin with. Now he's backing off on a high guard and being defensive. So he's harder to hit the ropes.
Backing off, but finding himself confined towards the ropes. David Hay looking incredibly relaxed. But a hereafter place at this point while the face of Jirjai has been reddened. And he's realizing that this is an entirely different sport from what he's been used to this point in his career. Precious little in the form of offense, haven't quite fully entered survival mode yet, but he's really not letting his hands go with any type of bad intentions through this point of the opening round. So Hay doing exactly as he likes, operating out of center ring. Jirjai just trying to stay out of harm's way and punching range.
Just closing him down, and he's going to walk him down, use that jab. Step in closer, he's not overreaching with his punches, and then land a shot up high and bring his guard down. Because he's been caging out Jirjai, he's keeping those hands very high, hard to hit him clean, so he's just got to be patient there.
Jirjai putting on the air muscle now, bracing his head with his hands, trying to repel and parry those shots. Had a crashing home from David Hay. Right hand strays around the back of Jirjai's head. All David Hay throughout the course of this opening round, toying with that left hand, looking to find an opening for his right. That put the man over in the first 40 seconds of round number one. And the right hand is knocked him down again. Jirjai is complaining that he's behind the back of the head. Yeah, he's hit
him
for a second time.
Yeah, a little bit of cardiology there. He's trying to get around with it. And referee Terry O'Connor done the right thing. He said, look, stop next.
It makes an ordinary day feel epic. Opens our eyes to amazing things. It can inspire us, comfort us, and bring us together. It doesn't just put the world in front of our eyes.
So we move into the second round. First round was a dramatic one as David Hay put his man on the floor twice, still not clear whether the second knockdown was counted. Referee Terry O'Connor did not issue a count, but after receiving a right hand that he complained was behind his ear and towards the back of the head, Arnold Jirjai sunk to the canvas for a second time after being dropped by a right hand straight down the pipe at around the 30-second mark.
Very happy about that.
I saw your fighter, Conrad, the middleweight, put a man on the floor with a left jab last week in Bristol. David Hay doing the same thing here. Sugar Ray Leonard put Wolf of Benitez on the floor with a straight left hand. Mel Brook did the same on his way to the world title as well. But it's a rare occurrence to see a boxer get floored with a jab. And Arnold Jirjai just appears to be looking to a place to fall.
Every time he's hit here,
isn't he? Yeah, appears to be looking to a place to fall here. Every time he's hit with a shot. David Hay, well, I'm sure we've received more opposition to the inspiring that he's receiving here. Arnold Jirjai being completely overwhelmed. And for the second time in the round, Arnold Jirjai has taken a trip to the canvas, completely
in the first round, then at the end of the first round, which we're not sure was counted. Then in the second round, he was dropped by a jab and then a crossroad puncher just sent him wobbling to the canvas. Arnold Tajai being exposed to a level completely beyond what he's been used to this point in his career. And David Haye continues his successful ring return as he continues to build momentum as he hopes to get himself back into contention for a shot at the heavyweight crown.
Yeah. Every time he hit this guy, more of a better chance of a look at it here. A solid looking jab. Let me have a look at it again. This is the end. He's chopping away around the side. Look at his legs every time he's hit on the head. His legs seem to be shaking right to the floor every single time he's hit.
Well, no disrespect to Arnold Tajai, but it was a step up in level. But I suspect that David Haye has received more opposition and more movement from the heavy bags in the gym than Arnold Tajai was able to offer tonight. Completely overwhelmed, completely outclassed. But as he